Nobody is talking about this strategy, and I don't remember where I got it, so heck, I'll take credit for it. I'm going to show you how to find high traffic, low competition keywords with the sleeper keyword research method. In one of my earlier videos, I showed you a list on untapped niche website ideas, and one of those ideas were touring motorbikes. And we're going to use that for this example. So when we are looking for ideas to write articles on, we always want to look at the first page on Google to evaluate what the competition is like. And finding a forum post or a website with a very low authority on the first page is usually a good sign. So this research method is building on doing the reverse of that. And that is why I call it a strategy, because it always works. It's not a tactic that works today and then doesn't tomorrow. It's a strategy where you look for areas that is not completely covered. And this is a general idea for publishing content online. And going backwards is going to increase the chances of you finding some really good ideas. One of the downsides to this method is that you will have to use a tool for this. So for this example, I'm going to use the free version of Ubersuggest, but you can also use Google AdSense keywords research thingy. But you will get more results if you use the paid version of Ahrefs or SEMrush. But for this example, the free version of Ubersuggest is more than enough. So let's have a look. One of the examples was touring motorbikes, and I'm looking for a forum. Oh, forum, like that. And we can choose one here. I'm choosing this one and not the .co.uk because I want more general traffic. I don't know if that's a thing or not, but let's have a look at this one. And Ubersuggest is going to give us some of the keywords that this forum website is ranking for. And it ranks for quite a lot of keywords. Of course, it will rank very low on a lot of these keywords, but it is on position one for quite a lot of keywords here. I don't pay so much attention to the SEO difficulty because it sort of contradicts the method here, because if the forum is on page one, it's by definition is lower competition. And maybe not low competition in all instances, but at least lower. One caveat to this is that if it's a forum post that is very well written with high quality content, it could definitely rank better than an article could. But most of the times it's not. So let's have a look at the list here. And they have all quite decent estimated volume. I don't know what this means. Some of these are for searches for the specific forum, so that is not interesting. This is for a specific type of motorbike, and if you know something about that one, that might be a good topic to write on. Motorcycle salesman might be also something to write on. Dry rut tires motorcycle, that could be a very interesting topic for an article. And Ubersuggest estimates 140 monthly searches. So let's have a look at the first page. And you can also do this directly in Ubersuggest. So the forum is actually number one. The Surfer plugin estimates also over 100 monthly searches. Reddit is also here. So, and maybe we can take a look to see if the forum post is a decent one, and it doesn't look like it. So we have found a good keyword here with a decent monthly volume. It's not zero anyway. Let's go further down the list. Here, BMW R something problems. Let's have a look at that. 140 estimated volume. And the Surfer plugin only estimates 20, but it's still not zero. And these are YouTube videos, And if you go down here, the same guy that is here, and he talks about another problem. And then we have another forum. So if you want to write a good article on the problems with this specific bike, you could definitely outrank some of this, even without a video, I think. So it might be interesting to write an article where you search all the forums you can find and watch all the videos you can find and make a complete list of things people have reported as problems with this bike. Maybe you can rank them in severity, and you can also rank how many times somebody has mentioned these problems. And if you know something about this bike, you can also chime in with your own experience. With the paid version, you would, of course, you can just go down the list here and continue. And with Ahrefs, you have the benefit of finding keywords for not the complete site as I did here, but also with individual articles. And that can be more helpful if you're writing on the topic where there's no specific forum that covers that topic. But if you're starting a completely new site, these two are more than enough to get you started. My advice is don't go out and pay for tools. Start by creating your website and start by writing these two articles. And when you have exhausted the list here and you get 3 searches a day, so if you have like 10 or maybe 20 articles in this manner, I think it could be a good idea to buy a tool. But until you have something live and you have written what you have already found here, I wouldn't recommend diving into that rabbit hole. You most likely are not going to get out anyway. So I hope you find this useful. I'm going to post more about this sleeper method and some of the more interesting details in this strategy. So stay tuned for that. Till next time. See ya.